I must say, some great filmmakers, great personalities associated with the film industry, when they leave this world, still the contribution to the film industry and their association with the people are always memorable. In that way, Yash Chopra is a remarkable personality. His life was remarkable in the film industry. His contribution to the film industry is phenomenal. Perhaps in the history of the film industry, a few persons' contribution and whose films are memorable and lives in the hearts of people. Yashji continuously for more than 60 years continuously has been a great director and filmmaker. I don't think in the film industry anybody could withstand continuously. There are so many great filmmakers, but he has had his own distinction by having for such a big span. Perhaps to my knowledge, in the Indian film industry, if you in every language there are great film directors, filmmakers, but they could survive for a little span of time. Such a big span of time is only Vyashji has achieved. Besides that, he has established his own style of making films, by making the visuality and the romance in a very dignified way, in touching the hearts and minds of the people, and creating a beautiful music, and making the artist to act in the highest way. He has succeeded. And I have been very closely associated with him. We have made a great films, Chandni, Lamhe, Vijay. These three films we have done jointly. Like that, we became very close. We have been produced these three films as partners, and these films made a big name and big success also for him financially. Like that, we have been inseparable friends for a few decades. So when he left this world and died untimely death, he was so active, aggressively used to work, and used to work very hard, and used to be always committed to make the best films. And most unexpectedly, God has taken away him, which we cannot deliver it. So, but at the same time, if you want to perpetuate a memory of a great personality, the best way is to institute an award in such great people's memory, so that once in a year, when you have the another talented personality, the award in the memory of such people, you are perpetuating his memory. That is, the function takes place and everybody remembers, yes, the Yash Chopra and so on. So with that philosophy, on the way of my foundation, TSR Foundation, which is committed for the promotion of art and culture in the country, so I instituted Yash Chopra's National Memorial Award 2 years back. So 2 years back, first year, we have selected and given the award to Lata Mangeshkar. The award carries 10 lakhs, gold medal and citation. So last year, the award was given to Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. So this year, our jury, the consisting of today, Pam Chopra, who is one of the jury members, Yash Chopra's wife. She has suffering from cold and fever. She couldn't come, but she sent the message about her choice also. So she is one of the jury members. Then myself, then Simi, a very distinguished personality, who gave a great contribution to the film industry, very knowledgeable, and a person who has made a mark in her own style and dignity and with phenomenal knowledge. So she is one of the jury members. And similarly, Mr. Bonnie Kapoor, who is a pride filmmaker, he has a distinction of making number of films and also making big films is with his brother Anil Kapoor and with Mr. India, Pukar, and so many films. He had a different style of making films. And incidentally, he is very fortunate that he is a husband of a great another big personality, Sridevi also, that's also there. This is his achievement in life. Then Jay Prada, always ever beautiful personality. According to me, She is a beautiful person, not only in the face, she is a very good-hearted person. In the film industry, she has a great culture. Besides that, as a film star, lady film star going to Uttar Pradesh, though she belongs to Andhra, and contesting elections in Lok Sabha, 10 years she has been Lok Sabha member and also took a very active part of the parliamentarian as the elected member of the Lok Sabha. Before that she was 6 years Rajya Sabha member also. So one side she has made this achievement, and second, other side, in the films she made a mark by acting in every language, the Hindi, Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, all languages of Indian language, important languages. She acted and she made a mark and established, so she is one of the jury members. Shashi Ranjan, Anu Ranjan, they are also remarkable persons. They have got the magazine and they also conduct the film, the awards for the women awards and the various awards. So they are both jury members. So all of us jury members, now today we had a long discussion and various options we have taken this. Then in conclusion, we have decided to give this award this year to Rekha for this award. So Rekha will receive the award, and we have fixed the date also of the function, because these days in Bombay, to get the accommodation of the good banquet hall is a bit difficult. Every day is events here. So I could fix January 25th with the same Marriott hotel. So January 25th we will have a glittering function where Rekha will be honored with the award. This thing. Then we will announce afterwards who are the distinguished personalities who will be participating in the function. We will tell later on. So this is the total this thing. So today, a jury consisting of all of us, we had finalized this thing. So once again I am repeating, the first year Lata Mangeshkar, second year Amitabh Bachchan, the third year this year Rekha. So this will carry 10 lakhs award, gold medal and citation. And 25th January it will be this. So if you have any questions, you can ask before others speaking. We keep on that relationship by instituting award and arranging every year in the memory of the function. Now I request Seema.
Seema, where is she? Hello, good evening. Nice to be here again. Every year goes by and it goes by so fast, but I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be part of this jury for this award. And I haven't said this before to Mr. Subbarama Reddy, but I really commend the effort that he's taking in keeping this award alive and in keeping the name of Yash Chopra alive. It's not being done for commercial gains. It's being done, the way I see it, just purely as a tribute to a very good friend of his and a very great filmmaker. And I think he deserves an applause for his gesture. I'm also happy to be here with the remaining jury members. I think Jay Pradhaji is absolutely lovely. And I remember when I was working with Satyajit Ray in a film, and I asked him at that time, who do you think is one of the most beautiful women in India? And Mr. Satyajit Ray said, I think Jaya Pratha is really beautiful and I would love to work with her. So, and I'm also very proud, I feel very proud when I see my fellow ladies making their name in politics and very avidly working at their in their métier, and I wish her so much luck, and I hope that she goes very far in her political scene. And as for Boney, Boney is so prolific. He's a real industry person. His family comes from the industry. They are the industry people, and he's so innovative. He has so much dynamism. And he's made great films, and I think he will continue to make great films, and I think he will continue to be a good friend to all the industry people. Well, I certainly think of him as a good friend of mine. And there's Anu and Shashi, always smiling. Notice them, always smiling. And always organizing things so quietly, doing their work very quietly. They are also great friends of the industry. They stride both television and cinema, which is not an easy feat, but they've done it. And I have nothing but good wishes for them, for their future and for every success. Thank you.
Now I request Mr. Boni Kapoor, a quiet filmmaker of country, will speak.
Good evening, everybody. Reddy Garu has spoken of his association with Yash Ji. Simi Ji has paid glowing tributes to Yash Ji, and of course, she mentioned about what Jaya Ji is all about. Jaya Ji needs no introduction, and the fact that she's mentioned what Satyajit Ray had to speak about her or think about her speaks volumes about her, not just her beauty, even her acting talent, because he at one point was keen to do a film with her. Besides, Shashi and Ranjan have been good friends of mine. Shashi, in fact, from his nascent days when he had just come into Bombay, he was Anil's colleague in the Film Institute, and I know him since then. And I'm glad to be part of this jury. In fact, Rekha Ji was one candidate who probably was unanimously selected, and I feel she deserves this, and she deserves much more than this. She started her career in 1970, and this is probably the fifth decade, and she's still around, shining as a diva, and she is probably amongst the most prolific actresses we've had in our industry. I wish the jury members, and I wish to thank the jury members to acknowledge her contribution to the film industry, especially to Mr. Subbiram Reddy, because with this award, he has underlined what talent means. It means a lot when it comes to, you know, honoring people like Rekha. And I wish this award greater glories, and I wish we can continue with this. This is something which Mr. Reddy has decided to do to honor the memory of the great filmmaker Yash Chopra. I've had some close interactions with him, and I feel he deserves all the glory that this award and his films have been bestowing on him, and I hope they continue to do so. Thank you.
Friends, I must say, also. So there are some artists, heroes or heroines, they establish the image as this best performance. See, normally a star is supposed to be the commercial. So Rekha has acted in a number of commercial films and offbeat films, and also number of films which gave her a big image and big name. So definitely the film goers and the people who love the artists and films, they're always will very happy for our choice to give Rekha, who made a mark with her brilliant performance, and she's always well known in the with people, and she's always, her performance lives in the hearts of people. Now I request Jay Prada to speak.
Good evening, everybody. Respected Reddy sir, Simi ma'am, Simi ji. Sri Simiji, Boni sir, Anu and Shashiji, good evening everybody. Today I'm really happy to be part of this jury, one of the junior members. And today it's a wonderful a decision has been taken by the jury. And we are recalling again SG's films, and it's wonderful to think about his films and his making. I think today's generation has to learn. It is like a library kind. his films are magnanimously successful, and as Reddy sir, he was talking about the first time they have chosen Lata Mangeshkar ji to have this award, and second time the great Amit ji, and today they have selected, the jury has been selected for Rekha ji. It's wonderful because her talent, definitely the people, today's generation also with connected, well connected, and the industry, what she has contributed to the industry, she has done so many magnanimous films, and thanks to Boni ji, he has also very busy person, but he has come all the way to give his views also on this award, and one of the best and successful producer Boni ji is also, because his advice is also very very important, and Shashi ji and Anu, they are all very close to for us, and Subbaram Reddy ji, I must thankful to Subbaram Reddy ji because he is member of parliament for so many years, he is in the parliament, but he's as a politician, he has made his place, but not only that, he is well connected to the industry also, so he has taking forward this Ash Chopra ji's award to give talented people, to acknowledge the talent in the industry and give them respect. It's wonderful, and I'm really thankful to you sir, because nobody have time for themselves, but he is giving so much of time and so much of he's showing the path to the talent, and he is acknowledging the talented people to give the respect to them. Thank you sir once again.
Yeah, once again I'm repeating, the award name is Yash Chopra National Memorial Award. The press, because please note on this exactly. Yash Chopra National Memorial Award carrying 10 lakhs. Now, Shashi Ranjan.
Good evening, everybody. Subbaram Reddy ji, Simi Garhwal, Jaya ji, Boni ji, and Anu. Thank you all of you as convener of this program. I thank you all for taking out your precious time to take a decision on honoring Rekha ji for this award. When Subbaram ji first time talked to me about this award, I was really impressed by two things. One is that unlike 90% of the awards which are completely commercial, he has no commercial interest in it, and that's a big thing. On the contrary, he's giving a big amount to the talent. So I really appreciate your gestures towards the industry, sir. It's a big thing. And till now, he has not even talked to me once that how can we commercially gain something out of it. It is just out of his passion for films and his friends in this film industry. So thank you very much, Subbaram ji, for this great step you have taken. And I'm sure in coming years, this award will grow more and more and have more strength, and more talent who's deserving in this industry will be honored on this platform. Thank you very much.
So any questions? You need anything, clarification? Nothing, no? No, tell me.
Hello.
Please tell loudly, slowly.
Good evening, everybody.
And how difficult was it to take the decision that it was not?
Hello. Hello, hello. Sir, Boni sir, मेरा प्रश्न आपसे है कि क्योंकि अब यश चोपड़ा जी अब हमारे साथ नहीं है, आप कितना सही मानते हैं जैसे अभी रेखा जी को अवार्ड दिया जाएगा तो आने वाले 10 या 12 सालों में जितने भी जुड़े थे कलाकार यश फिल्म से उनको सबको दिया जाएगा? और इसके बाद सर मेरा प्रश्न ये है कि आप यश चोपड़ा जी को क्या व्यूज देते अगर वो होते कि आपकी फिल्म में ये कमियाँ थी जो मैं ठीक करना चाहूँगा, ये खासियत थी जो आप हमेशा से करते थे सर, ये क्वेश्चन है मेरे।
हिस्सा किया था क्या पूछा था वेल ऑल द डिजर्विंग एक्टर्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर्स टू द फिल्म इंडस्ट्री वुड डेफिनेटली बी विल बी recognized by this platform, by this award, for sure. No, it would be even for actors and contributors outside Yash Raj films. And what was the second part? Have I answered your first question? It would be deserving candidates who work with Yash Ji and out of Yash Raj films too.
सर सेकंड क्वेश्चन मेरा ये था कि आप क्या कमियां आपको लगती हैं कि यश राज फिल्म में अब भी रह गई हैं या उसका सुधार आप करवाना चाहें और क्या खूबियां थी जो आपको बेहद पसंद थी यश राज फिल्म में
मुझे सिर्फ उनकी खूबियां याद हैं उन्होंने मतलब ही हैड अ फैंटास्टिक एस्थेटिक सेंस फैंटास्टिक स्टोरी टेलिंग सेंस ही गॉट द बेस्ट आउट ऑफ ऑल द एक्टर्स ही वर्क्ड विद एंड ऑल हिज फिल्म्स हैड अ वेरी वेरी प्लेजेंट लुक The entire environment that he created was really absolutely magical. So I feel there have been very few like him and there would not be many who would match his aesthetic sense. And I sincerely feel that he was one guy who had a fantastic he had a fantastic sense of communication with his actors, with his colleagues, with his entire team members. So खामियां ऐसे मुझे कोई दिखा नहीं देती देखिए फिल्में कुछ चलती हैं कुछ नहीं चलती हैं यश जी की ज़्यादातर फिल्में चली हैं जो नहीं चली हैं वो भी खूबसूरत पिक्चर थी ऐसी कोई पिक्चर उन्होंने नहीं बनाई जो कि आप बोल सको यार क्या पिक्चर बनाई है सो दैट वॉज वन बिग प्लस वेर ही इज कंसर्न देर इज नॉट बीन अ सिंगल फिल्म इन विच यू कैन पॉइंट आउट कि दिस इज नॉट प्रॉपरली डन और दिस इज नॉट एस्थेटिक दिस इज नॉट ही मेड ओनली फैंटास्टिक फिल्म ही मेड फैबुलस लुकिंग फिल्म एंड ही हैड The best of the actors working for him.
Sir, aapki personal favorite film Yash Raj banner se?
Meri personal favorite film thi Lamhe.
Lamhe.
Aur Lamhe se pehle Vakt.
Vakt.
Unki sabhi filmein mujhe bahut achhi lagi. But agar aap favorite pooch rahe to definitely as a youngster growing up, Vakt was the first multi-star cast. It was a trend-setting film.
Exactly.
In fact, that was the first multi-star cast film. This came in mid-60s. And after that, he's made some great films, some fantastic films. But my personal favorite was, not that I'm biased because Anil was there and my wife Sri was there, but it was, it remains my favorite film. It remains, and I'm sure like me, there'll be many others who would vouch for this. Because I've come across many, many people who have spoken volumes of how good the film was. And this is my personal opinion. I'm sure many would agree with me.
Sir, Yash Ji ke upar koi film bane unke jeevan par, to aap kisko cast karna chahenge agar aap banate hain to? Aap kisko cast karna chahenge? Kya star cast rahegi?
Here I'm getting there. Akhir ye abhi keh rahe hain to mujhe manna padega mere senior hai to main inko kuch bol nahi sakta.
To sir, hum expect karenge aane wale saalon mein aap introduce ho rahe hain.
अगर सुबीराम रेड्डी गारू ने साथ दिया तो क्यों नहीं जैसे इन्होंने यश जी के साथ मिलकर फिल्म बनाई थी या फिल्म शायद अकेले बनाएंगे क्योंकि यश जी एक तरफ उनके फ्रेंड भी थे उनके पार्टनर भी थे और फिल्म मेकिंग इनका भी पैशन रहा इन्होंने हिंदी नहीं तेलुगु फिल्में भी बनाई सो जब भी ये तय करेंगे एक फिल्म इंडिपेंडेंटली बनानी है तो माई सर्विसेज आर देयर फॉर हिम व्हाट एवर पार्ट ही वॉन्ट्स मी टू प्ले
सिमी जी स्ट्रेट हाय Yes. Simi ji, when we talk about Simi Grewal and Rekha in the same breath, we are reminded of that brilliant interview you did of Rekha and that brave question you asked Rekha about Amitabh. How was it? Was it easy asking her that question? How did you get her to open up?
It was easy asking that question. I think if I could ask Jaya Lalita ji, did she fall in love with MGR? Then for me, the Amitabh question to Rekha was much easier. And I don't find it, I know a lot of people keep saying to me, how do you get them to open up? I really don't know what I do. I don't know. I don't do anything special. It just happens. And I don't even want to analyze it because I remember once somebody told me that, they asked a caterpillar, okay, how do you walk? which foot do you put first? So the caterpillar kept thinking and thinking and thinking. Uske baad the caterpillar couldn't even walk because it couldn't, it didn't know which foot it should put first. So I'm not even going to think about it. I just chat, we're good friends. Rekha and I go back a long way. We go back to such a long way that when she made her first film at Rup Tara Studios, I was just telling him, I was making one of my, I think, first film also, second film, in Rup Tara Studios. She had the makeup room next to mine. We had run short of hairspray. My hairdresser hadn't brought hairspray. So she went and borrowed it from Rekha's hairdresser and then used it. And then before I left, I opened the door to thank her and I saw this young Rekha there, her first, you know, the first image of her, the way she was when she first came to Mumbai. And now, of course, she's metamorphosed into this glorious, glorious woman who's been, you know, an inspiration to other women. Well, you know, actually, let's be a little mature about it. You know, after all that controversy, I don't think it was an easy thing to happen. They're married man, children, grandchildren, and so much hangama and talk. You couldn't expect that to happen again. Though I do agree with you, they make a lovely pair on screen.
When you asked Simiji about Just Rendezvous, I think you people perhaps don't remember, she had made a fantastic documentary on Rajiv Gandhi and Raj Kapoor. In fact, they have been my personal favorite documentaries on Indian celebrities.
Jayaji, मेरा सवाल आपसे है. Jayaji, मेरा सवाल आपसे है कि आज के दौर में कौन सा ऐसा निर्देशक आपको लगता है जो यशराज जी का जादू जो चलता था फिल्मों में वो कायम कर सकता है?
देखिए, it's a very good question. But the thing is, मैं एक डायरेक्टर का नाम लूँ और दूसरे डायरेक्टर को मैं ही इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर दिस, ऐसा तो मैं नहीं बोल सकती हूँ कि ऑल द टैलेंटेड हु आर ऑल यू नो कैन गिव अ वंडरफुल लव स्टोरीज, दे आर ऑल फिट इन टू दिस बैनर. So we have so many directors in this industry who can give wonderful films also.
Good evening to the jury members.
I think the only other person who can take Yash Chopra's place is his son Adi Chopra.
Yeah, one more thing also you must accept. Yash Chopra ji has created a big base. After his passing of his son also is keeping up same tradition. Today in the Indian film industry, the Yashraj films is made a mark. Now so many big filmmakers made and afterward they couldn't sustain. It is because very peculiar situation of the film industry. But Yashraj films sustained and today also in the corporate system in a big way they are doing very successful and they are making so many films. And Adi is actually keeping up the prestige of father and they are very successful. And one more thing I must say, Yash Chopra's direction films, besides the great film Vakt, as Bani Kapoor said, the first film, multi-star film, this Diwar and Thrissul, phenomenal films. The way he created by Amitabh Bachchan and Shashi Kapoor, and also the dialogues, punching, and then Kabhi Kabhi, next film, then even Silsila. Silsila commercially not be that hit, but still it is a musical, beautiful film it was actually. Then Lamme, and internationally it was very well received and still people remember. And Chandni, Sri Devi's performance is actually matchless in that film. And they have both films, the Lamme and this one, Chandni. Similarly, Vijay also he had but a big lot of multi-star. Yes, she believed multi-star. And also always used to shoot in Switzerland and beautiful scenic beauty he used to create. And no unnecessary fights, most focusing on the story and the romance and beauty music and the family subject people used to love. So we really, my films are really monumental, I must say.
Good evening to the jury members. My question to you is, ESG is an iconic icon itself. We have also another icon, Dilip Sahab. And recently, Dilip Sahab was bestowed with the highest honor. My question to you is, the jury member, don't you think that Dilip Sahab's name was also should be recommended for the, you know, for the recipient for the award? What do you want to say about it?
I absolutely agree with you. I don't know what the others say, but I absolutely agree with you. And you know, now is the time to give it to them. These people are, he's 93, you know, this. We have to give it to them while they are here to appreciate it. Like somebody said, don't send me flowers at my funeral. If you want to give me flowers, give them to me now and I can enjoy them. That's what I feel too.
Ek aur sawal hai, Mr. Kapoor se.
One minute. Boni sir, please, you also comment on it.
See, aapne jo kaha bilkul sahi kaha aur Simi ji ne bhi sahi jawab diya hai. आज इसी दिलीप कुमार साहब को पद्म विभूषण मिला है. उसके बाद जितने भी अवार्ड मिलेंगे उससे मतलब मैच नहीं कर पाएंगे. एंड शायद इसीलिए उनका नाम लिस्ट में नहीं था जो हम आज डिस्कस कर रहे थे, बिकॉज ही इज बियॉन्ड सो मेनी अदर, यू नो. पद्म विभूषण इज द सेकेंड हाईएस्ट सिविलियन अवार्ड ऑफ अ कंट्री. And if at all we were in part of the jury for the Bharat Ratna, perhaps we would have discussed and given it to him. Aaj, I mean, not being disrespectful to this award, but the thing is, after getting Padma Vibhushan, if we honor him with this, it wouldn't be appropriate. In fact, he should be put up at a higher pedestal. I mean, as I said, agar Bharat Ratna ki jury mein hote, hum sab agree karenge. Kyun Simi ji? Unko अगर भारत रत्न की जूरी में हम होते तो हम उनका नाम आता तो डेफिनेटली उन्हीं को देते. तो उसके बाद पद्म विभूषण मिलने के बाद अगर हम कोई और अवार्ड की बात करें तो हम उनकी इज्जत पे, मैं ऐसा समझता हूँ कि उनकी जो इज्जत है वो पद्म विभूषण से जो बड़ी है, अब उससे आगे जानी चाहिए. ये अवार्ड है जो बाकी लोगों ने भी जो कंट्रीब्यूट, जैसे अमित जी को लास्ट ईयर मिला, उनको भी पद्म विभूषण उसके बाद मिला है. सी, पद्म विभूषण अमित जी को उसके बाद मिला है. आज पद्म विभूषण के बाद अगर कोई भी अवार्ड दिया जाता है किसी को, तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हम उनकी पूरी तरह इज्जत नहीं कर रहे हैं. उससे ऊपर का दर्जा उनको दिया जाना चाहिए. आई होप आई एम मेकिंग सेंस.
मिस्टर कपूर, हम सुपरस्टार्स की बात कर रहे हैं. आजकल के सुपरस्टार हैं सलमान खान, हु इज टर्निंग 50 दिस ईयर. मिस्टर कपूर, दिस साइड. हाय,
सॉरी.
या सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सुपरस्टार्स. हम सलमान खान इस साल 50 इयर्स के हो रहे हैं. आपने दो बड़ी फिल्में दी हैं उनके साथ और शायद नो एंट्री में एंट्री, द सीक्वल टू नो एंट्री इज ऑल्सो अवेटेड. सो आपकी क्या राय है उनके बारे में एज एन एक्टर? इस साल वो 50 इयर्स पूरे कर रहे हैं.
मेरी अकेले राय से क्या होगा, पूरी जनता जनार्दन उनके दीवानी है और उनके काम से मतलब इतने ज़्यादा प्रसन्न है कि आज की तारीख में सबसे बड़े स्टार हैं हिंदुस्तान के. और मेरी यही दुआ रहेगी कि ये सितारा हमेशा चमकता रहे, आगे बढ़ता रहे और भी बड़ा स्टार बने इंटरनेशनल फ्रंट पे.
थैंक यू सो मच.
मेरा सवाल सिमी जी और जयप्रदा जी से है. यश चोपड़ा ने बहुत सारी फिल्में बनाई और जिस तरह से रोमांस उनकी फिल्मों में दिखता था किसी और की फिल्म में नहीं दिखता था. बहुत रोमांटिसाइज करते थे चीज़ों को, ग्लोरीफाई करते थे. क्या अगर मैं एक सवाल पूछ सकूँ आप दोनों से कि कभी आप लोगों ने इमेजिन किया कि काश उस फिल्म में उस हीरोइन की जगह मैं होती? आप दोनों ने मतलब कि ये फिल्म में मुझे हीरोइन होना चाहिए यश चोपड़ा की फिल्म में?
हर एक फिल्म में आई विश हर एक फिल्म में मैं होती.
किसी एक फिल्म में अगर ज़्यादा आपको लगा हो.
अच्छा, पहले जय जी जवाब देंगे तब तक मैं सोचूंगी, फिर मैं जवाब दूंगी.
ठीक है.
ऐसा है कि हर फिल्म, जितना भी फिल्म हम लोग कितने लैंग्वेजेस में भी हम करें, लेकिन ऐसा लगता है कि मन नहीं भर रहा है. और एक फिल्म करो, और अच्छी फिल्म करो, इसी तरह रहता है. एस जी के साथ मेरा संबंध बहुत ही अच्छा है, अच्छा था. और मैंने उनके डाबर आमला का जो ऐड करने का टाइम बहुत लंबा जो ऐड किया मैंने, उसको बहुत काफ़ी समय दिखाया. उस वक्त कभी कभी फिल्म बनने के बाद मन में ये सोचा था कि खास मैं ये फिल्म किया होता तो कितना अच्छा होता. लेकिन वो तेलुगु ऑफर मुझे मिला तो मैंने उसको मैं तेलुगु में करने के बाद थोड़ा मेरे अंदर तसल्ली हुई है, लेकिन कभी कभी ऐसा लगता है कि आई मिस्ड हिम. इस बॉलीवुड के दौरान जितने फिल्म्स मैंने की सक्सेसफुल रहा, लेकिन कभी कहीं ना कहीं ऐसा लगता है कि मैं एसजी को मिस किया.
Your turn.
बहुत सोचा, आई कांट थिंक ऑफ एनीथिंग. आई वुड लाइक टू प्ले एनी फिल्म विद हिम, व्हिचएवर ही वुड हैव थॉट फिट. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, और इससे फायदा भी नहीं है क्योंकि अभी हो ही नहीं सकता, यू नो व्हाट आई मीन. सो इट डजंट मैटर.
अब क्योंकि हम एक्सरसाइज कर रहे हैं, ये अब देखिए, मैं सिमी जी का फैन बचपन से रहा हूँ. और मैंने मतलब इनकी जोकर फिल्म देखने के बाद मुझे ऐसा लगा था काश मेरी भी टीचर ऐसी होती. तो मैं ऐसा समझता हूँ द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट फिल्म फॉर हर ऑफ ऑल दी यश जी फिल्म वुड हैव बीन डर, जहाँ पे एक लवर भी और एक ऑब्सेसिव लवर भी है, मतलब सनी देओल भी था और एक ऑब्सेसिव लवर था शाहरुख खान. तो जू चाह डोंट गो बाय दैट. You know, I remember in my school days, there were many students, many of my colleagues who literally yearned for having a glimpse of Simi ji whenever she came on the screen and whenever she has written about the photographs. So there's definitely this thought in me that if at all she had to do a film for Yash ji, it could have been Dar in her prime time. Sorry, not that you're not in your prime time now.
जब हमारे बुजुर्ग ऐसे बातें करते ना तो फिर हमको चुप रहना पड़ता है. करेक्ट.
ओके,
नाउ
इन कंक्लूजन आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल फॉर प्रेशियस टाइम दे स्पेंड एज जूरी मेंबर्स एंड गिविंग द फाइनल डिसीजन ऑफ द अवार्ड विनर सिमी ग्रेवल, बोनी कपूर, माय जयप्रदा, अनुरंजन, शशिरंजन. आई थैंक ऑल ऑफ यू देम. And I thank all of you, the press, for having come with a great enthusiasm and spare a lot of time. And we also enjoyed. And you have taken a lot of information today. So it will be good, interesting for all the readers and also film goers for this conference. Thank you to all.
चाहेंगे थर्ड यश चोपड़ा जी का मेमोरियल अवार्ड दिया जाए. एंड यू आर बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ द ज्यूरी फ्रॉम द पास्ट टू इयर्स फ्रॉम नॉट रॉन्ग, सो व्हाट यू वांट टू से, हाउ डज इट फील? इट्स जस्ट लाइक अ रिस्पांसिबिलिटी यू नो टू अवार्ड समवन. तो क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप इसके बारे में?
इट्स यू नो इट्स अ वंडरफुल थिंग टू अवार्ड समबडी. आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ अस इन दिस फिल्म इंडस्ट्री वी वर्क फॉर एप्रिसिएशन एंड वी वर्क फॉर नॉट ओनली अवार्ड्स एंड रिवॉर्ड्स बट जस्ट फॉर पीपल टू से वेल यू वर ग्रेट दिस ईयर और वी थिंक यू आर वंडरफुल एंड वी वांट टू ऑनर यू. And I think that's what we're trying to do with this award function. We're trying to honor the people who have contributed so much, who are legends in their own lifetime. I mean, Lata ji, who can compare to her? Amitabh Bachchan, he's phenomenal. And now Rekha ji, who's unique. You know, she's, for me, it's a double pleasure because not only is she a great actor on screen, but she's a personal friend of mine and somebody who I really get on very well with, and I love her. She's a wonderful person. There is not even a dot of negativity in her. There's nothing but goodness flowing from her. Believe me, we talk for 4 hours on the phone at a time, and as soon as we finish our conversation, I feel so good. She makes you feel very good being with her.
आपके लिए अवार्ड कितना स्पेशल है? यशराज जी का जो स्पेशल अवार्ड है आपके लिए, ये अवार्ड कितना मायने रखता है? कितना स्पेशल है आपके लिए?
नहीं, मुझे तो खुशी है कि हम लोगों को जिन्होंने इतना काम किया है, इतना बढ़िया काम किया है, जो लेजेंड्स हैं हम उनको ऑनर कर रहे हैं, करना चाहिए. और मैं हमेशा सोचती हूँ, यू नो, जैसे किसी ने सवाल पूछा था कि यूसुफ साहब, दिलीप साहब के लिए अवार्ड, आई फील जब हम लोग जिंदा हैं, जब हम सब जिंदा हैं, तभी सब प्यार और मोहब्बत और फूल और अवार्ड सब देने का टाइम होता है. और मुझे इस बात का बहुत अफसोस होता है कि जब लोग पॉस्थ्यूमस अवार्ड्स देते हैं और जब कोई गुजर गया है या कोई सोल्जर भी गुजर गया है और तब देते हैं, तो तब क्या फ़ायदा है? उसको तो पता भी नहीं है, उसको तो उसका असर भी नहीं, उसकी खुशी भी नहीं वो महसूस कर सकता है. मुझे यही लगता है.
सिमी, कहीं ना कहीं दिलीप साहब को भी ये अवार्ड पहले ही दिया जाना चाहिए जो
मुझे लगता है. जी, मुझे लगता है
उनको बहुत ज़्यादा एहसास होगा.
मुझे लगता है कि पहला अवार्ड उन्हीं को जाना चाहिए था, लेकिन ये तो सब जूरी की बात है, सब लोगों को ये सोचना चाहिए और सब फील करना चाहिए, लेकिन ये मेरे हिसाब से ये सही बात डोंट यू थिंक बहुत लेट था, क्योंकि अभी जब वो पद्मा विभूषण भी आया था तो मुझे लगा जैसे कि वो उनको उनका ध्यान नहीं था उस पर, और सब हमेशा हम लोग दादा साहब फाल्के अवार्ड देते हैं जब लोग बूढ़े हो जाते हैं, बीमार बूढ़े क्यों भाई क्यों।
मैम वन लास्ट थिंग, यश चोपड़ा मेमोरियल अवार्ड इज अ ग्रेट ऑनर फॉर एनी एक्टर, बट इन रीसेंट टाइम्स टॉकिंग अबाउट द रीसेंट करंट जनरेशन, डू यू थिंक एनी ऑफ द एक्टर, इफ यू वांट टू नेम एन एक्टर हु कैन यू नो हु कैन हु इज यू नो एलिजिबल इनफ टू रिसीव दिस ऑनर, हु वुड बी इट?
शाहरुख खान, definitely Shahrukh Khan, Salman Khan, they've all not only I think they've acted in his films, haven't they? I don't
yeah, Shahrukh Khan is a personal favorite of yours.
I think Shahrukh is very deserving of the award simply because, you know, they reinvented romance in Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge and set a new standard of romance. And Shahrukh is on screen is magic. He is pure magic and I'm totally in love with him.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
You're watching Filmi Mantra. I'm Simi Garibal and you're watching Filmi Mantra.
कैसा रहा आपका ये कार्यक्रम और क्या आप समिति से आप लोगों ने रेखा जी का नाम पारित किया?
जी सबसे पहले मैं इस जूरी में रहना मुझे बहुत ही अच्छा लगा, और क्योंकि ये खुशखबरी है क्योंकि आज ये जो एस जी का जो इंटरनेशनल अवार्ड उनके मेमोरियल अवार्ड मिलना और रेखा जी को ये नवाजा गया जाने वाले हैं, तो इस खुशखबरी को लेकर हम आपके सामने आए हैं, मुझे बहुत ही खुशी हुई है। ख़ास तौर मैं धन्यवाद कहना चाहती हूँ सुब्रह्मण्य रेड्डी जी को उनके दोस्ती के लिए, एस जी के साथ जो सुब्रह्मण्य रेड्डी जी का जो दोस्ती के वजह से आज इस महत्वपूर्ण इस अवार्ड को जो टैलेंटेड हो और लेजेंड्स हो उन लोगों को इस अवार्ड्स को देने के लिए तय किया है। सबसे पहले इसको इस अवार्ड को लता जी को दिया था और उसके बाद श्री अमित जी को दिया, और ये तीसरी जो अवार्ड है रेखा जी को देना। रेखा जी के साथ मुझे एक फिल्म में काम करने को मौका मिला और मैं उनके फिल्म्स देखते देखते हम बड़े हुए हैं, और आज उनके लिए जूरी में बैठ कर उनके टैलेंट को पहचानने के लिए एक मौका दिया गया, और इस अवार्ड के लिए जितने जूरी बैठे हैं और बोनी जी हों या सुब्रह्मण्य रेड्डी जी हों, सिमी अग्रवाल जी हों, वैसे ये अनु जी और शशि जी, ये सब जो है एक जूरी बैठ कर एक इस अवार्ड को एक टैलेंट को पहचान कर उनको सम्मान करना ये बहुत बड़ी बात है, और इंडस्ट्री को एक पहचान देना, और इंडस्ट्री हम किसी से कम नहीं है, क्योंकि कोई भी आर्टिस्ट अगर अच्छी फिल्म को लेकर एक अच्छे परफॉर्मेंस अगर करेंगे तो सिर्फ एसजी के फिल्म्स के सीमित ना रहते हुए बाहर फिल्म्स को भी मौका दे रहे हैं। ये हमारे लिए रेखा जी भी बहुत ही खुशनसीबी मैं मानती हूँ, क्योंकि नॉर्मली साउथ से नॉर्थ आने पर बहुत ही दिक्कत होती है, क्योंकि लैंग्वेज के हिसाब से या कल्चर के हिसाब से ये देखते हुए, लेकिन हम लोगों के लिए एक फिल्म्स जो है जो हम लोगों ने जो फिल्म सेलेक्ट किया है उस फिल्म्स को द्वारा लाइक मैं अगर मेरा द्वारा जो है जो भी अगर सरगम के द्वारा मैं पहली फिल्म मानकर मैं आई हूँ तो इस इंडस्ट्री ने मुझे स्वागत किया और आशीर्वाद दिया और लोगों ने भी बहुत प्यार किया।
मैम कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस काफ़ी रही है, अभी रिसेंटली हमने आपका और श्री जी को साथ में देखा, तो दैट इज़ अ बिग मोमेंट। आपको लगता है आपके ज़माने में आप लोग कॉम्पिटिटर्स थे, नाउ कमिंग टुगेदर ऑन द सेम स्टेज?
यस, इट टुक 25 ईयर्स, मोर देन 25 ईयर्स फॉर अस, एंड बट ऑलवेज आई ट्रीटेड हर दैट शी इज़ माई यंगर सिस्टर, बट शी इज़ also a wonderful actress. And hum logo jitne bhi hum logo ne kaam kiye hain chahe hindi mein ho ya telugu mein ho we are really a very healthy competition hum logon ke hote the to healthy competition zarur hona chahiye taki hum logon ke jo talent ko andar se bahar nikalne ke liye ek wajah to zarur chahiye aur touch wood hum log jis media ke dauran hum logon ko rivals mante the lekin usi media ke dwara hum log phir se hum log dosti ke maqam tak pahunche hain aur is दोस्ती हमेशा कायम रहे।
मैम आपको लगता है आजकल की एक्ट्रेसेस में ये दोस्ती है ऐसी रहती है?
एक्चुअली इंडस्ट्री में कोई किसी का दोस्ती इतना टाइम नहीं मिल पाता है तो हर रोज़ हम लोग मिलके दोस्त बोलने के लिए भी इतना समय नहीं रहता है। आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट बट इंडस्ट्री में और भी अच्छे अच्छे टैलेंट्स आए हैं, यंगस्टर्स आए हैं और भी अच्छी फिल्म्स बने हैं तो इंडस्ट्री में कंपटीशन इवन द टेक्नोलॉजी वाइज आल्सो बहुत ही कंपटीशन रहा है।
जब एक ज्यूरी किसी एक स्टार को किसी एक सेलिब्रिटी को अवार्ड देना चाहती है तो आप ज्यूरी में मेंबर्स में कभी मतभेद होते हैं कि नहीं इसको नहीं इसको नहीं
होना चाहिए क्योंकि अगर आप उसके बारे में विश्लेषण के रूप में अगर आप डिस्कस नहीं कर पाते हैं, विस्तार से डिस्कस नहीं कर पाते हैं, प्लस माइनस बात नहीं कर पाते हैं तो फिर हम जूरी के लिए न्याय नहीं कर पाते हैं। तो हम जितना जो पहले जो अवार्ड्स दिया है उस अवार्ड्स को भी हम सामने रखते हुए किस आधार पर इसको सेलेक्ट किया गया है हम उसी टेबल पर हम डिस्कस करते हैं और जो भी हम लोगों को प्लस माइनस बात करना तो उसी समय पर बात करते
हैं। चलिए इंडियन एक्ट्रेसेस going to Hollywood now. इसको आप किस नज़र से देखते
हैं? बहुत अच्छी बात है। नहीं, बहुत अच्छी बात है क्योंकि हमेशा एक प्रमोशन की ज़रूरत है। हम लोग जब रीजनल फिल्म्स करते थे तो लोग कहते थे कि अरे आप तेलुगू और हिंदी तेलुगू तमिल ये सब कर रहे हैं, आप कब बॉलीवुड में जाओगे? अब मैं बॉलीवुड में आने के बाद लोग हमें भी पूछते थे कि आप हॉलीवुड फिल्म्स को करने का मन है कि नहीं। यू नो, यहाँ पे पहले से अब एक अपॉर्चुनिटीज बड़े हैं क्योंकि एक कोलैबोरेशन के रूप में लोग जो हैं जैसे अमेरिका इंडो अमेरिका कोलैबोरेशन है वैसे हम लोगों को कोलैबोरेशन के रूप में एक गठबंधन जो हो रहा है आजकल तो ये हॉलीवुड में टैलेंट दिखाने के लिए एक ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी है, प्लेटफॉर्म भी है।
मैम, गॉर्जियस एज ऑलवेज, कैन यू जस्ट पोज फॉर आवर कैमरा?